Hey guys, it's Katie at scrappingkatie.ctmh.com, and I have a quick process video to share with you showing how to make this shaker card with a couple of thin cuts from Close to My Heart, as well as the May 2019 special called The World Is Yours. I've already pre-cut my card pieces for a standard size card, and I've pulled my shaker window in confetti thin cut for these three largest circles, and then my stitch circle thin cut for that smallest circle. So now I'm going to show you how to cut these circles so hopefully they line up. You want to start with your largest piece or your front piece, and so that measures 4 1/4 by 5 1/2, and cut that largest circle out of there. Then the next layer, I'm using espresso cardstock and I'm using the light side, and I'm going to cut that second largest circle, which is the star confetti, and just washi tape it down and run it through my die cut machine. After that's cut, I'm going to clean up my mat a little bit, making sure to save those star confettis for the shaker window. Then I'm going to cut my next layer, which is the sage cardstock, and I'm going to use that heart confetti from that thin cut and run that through. And then off camera, I cut that stitch circle from the peach cardstock. And so now I'm just trying to decide which of these cute little suitcases I want to show through that back window. So now I'm going to adhere all my pieces together, and I am just using regular Tombow adhesive. All four layers are going to create enough dimension that I don't need added dimension by foam tape. And it is okay if the backs aren't lined up, as long as those circles are lined up. It also doesn't matter whether you start from the smallest circle or the largest circles. As you can see here, I kind of split it, and then I'm just going to adhere these two pieces together, making sure those circles are lined up. And as you can see, that peach cardstock hangs over just a little bit, so I'm going to trim off the excess with my micro tip scissors. And then I'm going to line that up on my card base and mark the center with a watercolor pencil, so I'll know exactly where to adhere down that suitcase B&T. So now I'm going to start assembling the shaker window. So I have pulled my shaker window foam and acetate sheet, one of each. And the easiest thing for me to do is take something sharp. So I'm using my micro tip scissors here. I've also used a paper piercer before. But what you want to do is you want to run it through and separate that adhesive bond between that outside circle that creates the window and all those little extra inside foam squares. So once I've done that, I'm just going to start to peel back that backing and then take my anti-stack pouch and run over that B&T so my sequins will behave. And then I'm going to take my eraser and start to peel back that acetate sheet protective covering. Then I'm going to adhere down that thin circle. And that's the only thing that's going to actually adhere to my card base. So these inside pieces should pop out rather easily. Then I'm going to take all that confetti, the hearts and the stars that I've saved, and put in there, as well as some rose gold sequins. So I've already assembled my shaker window, and that acetate sheet is already in place. Then I've used all those extra foam squares to adhere that top panel to my card base. Then I'm going to take the stamp set that goes with The World Is Yours and pull out a sentiment and some espresso ink and just stamp that on a scratch piece of white daisy cardstock so I can fussy cut it out. So when I fussy cut, I like to use really sharp scissors, and Close to My Heart's micro tip scissors are perfect for this. They're small enough that they can get in and out of little bitty crevices, but they're also pretty mighty as well, so they're good for bigger projects. So one tip about fussy cutting, it's best if you leave your scissors stationary and if you just move the cardstock around. It leads to a crisper image, and it's just easier to cut instead of always having to move your scissors around. So as you can see on that flower and the sentiment, I like to leave a white edge around my image when I fussy cut. It just gives the image crisper lines, and if you were to mess up, you really can't tell as much if there's a white edge around it. So now I'm going to adhere all these pieces down. I'm going to use our liquid glass, which has a fine tip applicator attached to it. So I'm going to adhere those leaves down, and then I'm going to apply some thin 3D foam tape to the back of the sentiment. And Close to My Heart has thin 3D foam tape as well as regular. I like the look of thin because it gives it some dimension, but not too much, especially if you're mailing the card. And then I'm going to pull out some thin 3D foam circles for that flower. For the inside sentiment, I am pulling out the May 2019 stamp of the month that you can get during the month of May for as little as $5 for the qualifying order. That birthday is inked up in espresso and girl is inked up in peach. So now to add a little bit of shimmer to this card, I've pulled out our gold shimmer brush and I'm just going to add some shimmer to the center of that flower as well as to this espresso circle that's there. It didn't add much, but it added enough and I think the card needed it. So there you go. Thanks for stopping by.